turbo, baby, singular. That's what we've got here in the N54. We have got the single turbo done, ready to go, and we're about to fire it up for the first time. I don't have everything 100% done here, but got it at least to the point that we can go ahead and try to start the engine. We got everything to set up to do that, put some gas in it. We went ahead and primed the oil feed to the turbo, and now we're gonna jump in there and see if we can get this thing to start. So odds are probably pretty low. If it does start, I'm guessing we're gonna have a lot of check engine lights and codes going on, but let's go ahead and give it a turn on and see what happens. All right, let's see what we got, car. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Ho ho! Ho ho! She started. She did not sound good. Let's give it one more rippy here. Ho ho ho! She's running, baby! Dude! She sounds mean! Oh yeah! Oh no! We've got turbo, baby! That doesn't sound... Well, we've got turbo and a lot of liquids dripping. Okay. See where that's coming from. Well, you guys probably saw that gnarly leak we had going on under there. Based on the smell of it, I think it's a fuel leak. But now that we've got the hood here, I'll just show you what we're working with. I went ahead and can't remember where we left off last place, but I got everything back in here that needs to be in here. The charge pipe's back on. We've got the intercooler fully set up, the turbo's mounted, I've got my three-port max solenoid running. I've got the port injection set up, but it's not actually wired in. That's really the only thing I have left to do is to wire in the JB4 port injection controller to my existing JB4. Then obviously we've got to get some tuning done on it. I still have a little bit of cleanup here with these wires and things like that. This is pretty hot right here, even after just running for a couple minutes, and so I'm gonna wanna do some type of heat shielding around all of this electrical stuff over here. But other than that, everything is set up. We've got a couple weird things going on. There's some random hoses all over the place that I plugged up, and there's a lot of sensors throughout this thing that are unplugged, but it starts, and that's all that matters for right now. And I got the catch can set up, so at some point we might switch to an external PCV, but right now we've just got the RB PCV upgrade and the vent to atmosphere catch can set up in here. But now what I'm gonna do is try to figure out where this fuel leak's coming from. Considering the fueling stuff that I touched was the port injection fueling line that sits down here under the charge pipe, I'm guessing that's what was leaking, but it's hard to tell. I'm probably gonna have to pull the charge pipe off here and see. It doesn't really seem that wet under here. The majority of the fuel that was dripping towards the transmission actually. And so I don't know if it was spraying from somewhere down here all the way backwards, but we're gonna have to pull some stuff apart here to get a little bit better of a look at it. So I guess I'm gonna go ahead and take some of this stuff off, and we'll go ahead and give you guys an update once I figure out exactly what it is. All right, guys, so it's hard to tell, but the 135 is officially off of the lift. We have the 535i on the lift now, as I need to do some work to that, but this car is back on the ground, at least made it from the other spot to this spot in the garage. Last thing we showed was the massive fuel leak that was going on underneath this car when we started it up for the first time. Fortunately, fixing that was relatively easy enough. I took the 6 fuel injector off back here when I was setting up the catch can and PCV setup, and I just didn't tighten it down enough. So we were getting a pretty good fuel leak out of the number 6 fuel line. And then we also had a leak coming from the right side of the car all the way down under here, underneath the intake manifold. We had a leak coming from the port injection fuel line. So I just had to pop that off, tighten it a bit, and now we have no leaks from there. We did have a small leak right here at the turbocharger from the turbocharger oil feed line. It initially was leaking from the bottom side, but I went ahead and just tightened that up pretty easily and that fixed it. And then it had a small leak from the top, but that got fixed nice and easily as well. And then the only other thing I've done since then is I went ahead and took these two original vacuum lines here. I initially just plugged and capped both of them off, but I went ahead and just routed them to each other to give a continuous flow rather than having them capped off. And I think that made the engine run a little bit better. But for now, everything is at least set up properly. From here, I just need to get my JB4 wired in properly, get the port injection set up for that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and run a back end flash through MHD, just a base single turbo map right now. Once I have the initial tuning or some base tuning set up for it, I'll be able to diagnose whether there are any actual problems with the setup. I feel like there might be a vacuum leak somewhere, but it's kind of hard to tell when it's not properly set up and tuned properly. We're gonna go ahead and get that put on here. For now, we'll go ahead and turn it on and just let you guys hear how it's running right now without any of the tuning set up. There's some sketchy noises that it makes right when it starts up, and then it seems to run fine for a little bit, and then it has a bit of a rough idle where there's kind of some surging and some bouncing going on. That's what I need to diagnose, but it's going to be tough to do that until the tuning's actually set up. So I'll show you guys what it looks like, and then we'll be back the next video, hopefully actually putting this on the street and showing you a little bit of what it's got. Those are the sketchy noises right there. Don't know exactly what it is, but it seems to do okay after that. Idle picks up a little bit, and then once it gets back down to about the 800 RPM range is when it starts to get a little finicky. But if I give it a little bit of throttle and hold it around 1500 or 2000 RPMs, there's no problem with it at all. Seems like it's running at least well enough to where I'm happy with it right now, without having any of the tuning taken care of and things like that. And so hopefully once we get that set up, this thing will be running a lot nicer. The only other thing I need to figure out is the smell, because this thing smells just absolutely awful right now, but it does sound really cool. But anyways, guys, this is how it's running right now. Like I said, we're gonna go ahead and, oh, and there the drop in the idle is. It falls down to about 500 RPMs, and from there, you know, it gets a bit shaky,